Hi there. In this video, I'm going to attempt to repair some bulbs with parts from other similar bulbs. Let me try to explain our situation here. This one failed a day after I bought it. It just went off and that was it. This one worked for 2 years maybe. As you can see, it's quite dark in this area. It flickered a while and then it stopped working. They are identical, or at least almost identical. The most important thing is they have the same power rating, which is 33 watts. What I am going to do, I have another video that I will link in the description. I tried to put a PCB from another type of CCFL bulb, but that PCB was too weak. Some people commented on that video that I could try and change the capacitors just to give it a bit more power to drive this. I decided I'm going to wait for another one to go off of the same capacity. If it's a bit more powerful, it should work. If it's lower power, probably it won't. These two are identical in power, it should work. For this one, I'm expecting that what failed was the tube itself. And the electronics is still in good shape. This is a new tube. You know what, where I'm going with this. Electronics from this one, tube from this one. Yep, should be nice. But let's see how I glued this thing together, because it seems to be glued. Yay. And these ones, a friend again gave me this. We bought the same type of bulbs. Mine, one of these two, not sure which, worked for more than 2 years. This one, for him, maximum of few weeks, it flickered and it died. This one, it worked more even for him, maybe about a year, and then it died too. I will try to open them. This is glass, quite thick, so for at least one of them, I will cut under the glass itself. I will cut through the plastic, although it's really, really thick plastic, but I will cut under the glass to save at least one of the glasses. If I can fix, I need a glass to put on. And the other doesn't really matter how I will crack it open. And hopefully, at least for one of these, the LEDs are actually the problem, because this, from what I see, has good LEDs. None of them seem to be burned out. With that black dot on them, which signals they are interrupted. Guessing at this point, that's second job. This is first job, because in this one I have been before and I quite know what we can find and do. You can see here the smaller PCB that wasn't quite up to the job. It tried to light up this thing, but it never could. And I just realized I didn't show you how these things behave. Actually, you know what? These things are unplugged for more than a year. Yeah, no, I'm no, sorry, not showing you how they behave, because I'd rather stay alive and not electrocute myself. So yeah, that's that. Maybe, but let's see, is this some kind of HCI? What voltage? 6.5 microfarads at 400 volts. So this can potentially kill you if you insist. I'm just going to wiggle it off until I break its leads, because again, this board is useless to me. It's not able to power this bulb itself, so I don't care what happens to it anymore. And as you can see, I've put Kapton tape. That's how it's called. Come on, when you need to break some leads of a capacitor, you can't, but they will break for themselves when you don't want to. It's ideal they remained in there so they cannot harm anybody. You cannot get electrocuted from that thing anymore. And this, there is nothing that should hold the charge in here. So again, I've put some Kapton tape on this to make sure nothing shorts out. Yeah, this will be a long video, as most of my videos are actually. If you are wondering why I'm cutting all of these, I plan to use this top on the bottom from here. But yeah, obviously, let's see how we can open up this one. Which again, this tells us the tube failed. Let me try and see where we have the clips themselves. Yeah, that's not going to be an easy task, is it? Genuinely don't even remember how I managed to get that first one open, because this doesn't seem to want to come apart. And the fact, now I remember, this was used, so the plastic in this one probably is more brittle than in that one, so this will not come apart easily. What I could do to make sure the bottom remains unharmed, I could try to cut into the top. Okay, this has mercury in it, so if you do this, be careful not to break the glass itself. Safety glass is on, and high speed video will follow. That didn't quite work as expected, and I needed to go full Neanderthal on it. Yeah, it is what it is. Let's just simply... I'm not going to be able to use this case. Luckily, this one is in better shape. The plastic in this one, because of all the years of use, became really, really, really brittle. So... yeah, and I just realized what I'm doing now is quite stupid, using this full metal to cut... how is this? Cutter? Plier? It's not pliers. Wire cutter. To cut the wires, but normally this wasn't used for more than a year, and it shouldn't have any voltage in the high voltage area. So, this recycling. Let's put it aside. And let me just see what kind of access we have to the board in here, because this is what we want, to get it out and move it to the other one. Or actually, could I? Yeah, I think I should. Why did you break? I don't see anything blown. Yes, they are dark as hell from what they did working for 2 years. Anyway, let's see what I have in here. Yeah, I have the original blue and red wires. Yep, I can move everything in this one. And as you can see, this is where something went catastrophically wrong. And some parts of it blew up after one day of use, or how much that was. The capacitor doesn't seem to be bulging, so yeah, I'm fairly confident this electronic is still working. And one small problem, I was a moron and didn't look how the wires were actually connected. Let's see if I can still figure that out now. This is how I cut them, or at least this is how I think I cut them. This was... nope, this is how I cut them. Because this was in here like this. Yikes, does it even matter? Or I just need to have two on each side, and then the discharge between them will happen in any way. Yeah, I think I just need to have two on each side. That should be good enough, shouldn't it? We'll see. Let me explain what I need to do now. I need to extend these two wires with these two, which are taken from the one that I needed to throw away. The problem is, I need something heat resistant, and on top of it I will just put this thing to keep it in place. Yes, if I would have planned this from the beginning, probably I would have been able to use at least the wires from this thing or the ones from that didn't plan ahead. Now I need to extend the wires, and they are somewhat weird because they have a single middle wire, a single copper wire. So I don't like if I would need to completely change them with something else, although that I think would be the better choice, wouldn't it? Let me see what I have. It would be better to simply have two wires that go directly in instead of this crazy weirdness. Let me see. Yeah. Did you ever have a day when you felt your brain was simply not working? Because I'm having one now. This is not supposed to be on the table, it's supposed to be here. I tried to make a hole so I can get my quite thick wire directly through it and solder it inside what I need, and then exactly at the proper length, cut it and solder it on the outside. So I have zero wire tangled up in weird positions inside between these components. Yeah. Didn't know how this thing was made, and it seems it actually has a middle which is somehow pressed in there. And when I cut it off, I simply cut off the top of it. So this is not usable anymore. But then at least I could drill a hole in this thing. But I don't think this one is even enough for the wire, and it's actually not. So I have where to attach the second wire. But this is Gonski, the one that was blown inside and had just a tiny crack somewhere here. So we are back to using the one that worked for a while but has a huge crack. So I will need to use Krypton tape in here just to make sure everything stays together. Yeah. Brain not working today. Nothing more, nothing less. In case you did not figure it out yet, this is not worth it. It takes too long. Yes, I did make a few stupid decisions, so yeah, that's on me. But these things are not meant to be repaired. You can, and hopefully it will work, but yeah, anyway. So I have the proper wires now. They are soldered, one here and one I drilled a hole in here and soldered it to the edge. outside the thread itself, so it doesn't do anything, it doesn't interfere. Soldered them onto the board, somewhere around there. And now these four wires, they actually go into place, so I cannot mix them up. These normally from the factory are just turned around these posts right here. Well, I don't have anything that could turn them tight enough for this to work directly without soldering, so I will do a bit of soldering at the end just to make sure they make contact. High voltage, I'm not sure if it's high temperature, although it shouldn't be because everything is on a PCB. How big of a temperature could that make? And outside is plastic, so yeah. And the capacitor, if this was really high temperature inside, this would have died quite soon. So let's continue. And it's done. Hopefully it will actually work, but that obviously remains to be seen. So let's put this back together. I'm not going to put any glue this time in it. Make sure the wires go nicely in there and don't touch anything that they shouldn't. And from what I see, they don't, which is perfect. This thing needs to be aligned. It has a line down there and one on the rest of the bulb. And it locked in place and yeah, looking quite bad. Now I will use a file to clean up this mess and then tape, as I said. And that's about it. Looking quite bad. Honestly, it's looking quite bad with this tape on it, but this will not be affected by the high temperature. It just doesn't care about it. And everything inside should be perfectly good to go. Yes, it's maybe not the best idea to touch these things, but I don't think it actually affects them. They tell you not to touch them because people try to screw the bulb down by this and they break them. So even if I put my hands, I will wipe it down the glass, but shouldn't matter. So yeah, all that remains, let's give it a test and hope it works and doesn't just blow. But if it blows up, at least you get some nice fireworks next. And what do you say about this? This thing is working perfectly. And that one is close to its end. As you can see, it has a lot of black at the ends, but this one, as long as the electronics is able to hold onto this one for its lifetime, but probably the electronics will fail because they are not meant to work this long. I don't think they are able to take the lifetime of two glass elements, but anyway, yeah, working perfectly. Looking bad, but working well. And that one is full of little, I don't know, little something. Anyway, glad it's working. A lot of work needed to be done, but at least it wasn't for nothing. So let's continue with the lead ones. Today being the day of bad decisions, probably I will guess wrong which one of these two to cut. Because if I cut the one that actually has good electronics but bad LEDs, that's not quite okay. But there are two variants: smash the glass, cut the plastic. That's about it. Nothing else will work with this. This one was opened up by smashing the glass itself. So yeah, that's about it. Let's do this in high speed, it will take a long while. Well, snap, this one has good electronics, but this little LED right there blew up. So, for the next one, I'm smashing the glass. and hoping that I find the same thing in here, because here we have good LEDs. I can put good LEDs. I have a good glass in a, and if I have good electronics from three of them, I can make a good one. If this has bad electronics, I'm screwed. So let's see. Yep, we are done. If you ever need to smash something like this, put it into some cloth, I don't know, an old t-shirt, whatever, into some, let me just get it, into some newspaper on the outside, and then just give it a good old whack with something sharp, and obviously wear these things, just in case. And now let's see what we got in here. For real. How unlucky could I be? This one has bad electronics. So the only one with good electronics is this one, which I cut, not smashed. This is not even funny anymore. So I need to get rid of all this glass. Worst possible way is how I'm doing it with my hand. Anyway, let's get to high speed. Maybe I can move the electronics from one to the other, although I don't really think so. This is a bad idea. Glass flying everywhere, so I need to go somewhere where I don't care if it flies away, wear eye protection, and get rid of all that glass in there. Although before, let me just check on this one if I can actually remove the internals of it, because if I can't, nothing that I do even matters anymore. And the bad board is out, and there is no way to get this. I will try and get one of them off just by cutting a tiny bit more around it. I don't really know if that would be enough, but anyway, I can probably pry one out, and if I cut, I don't know, I will, from T3 bulbs, I'm hoping I can make something good. I need to get this one in good shape, because this for sure, the LEDs are good on it. It crept out too soon to be a LED problem. Let me just show you how you can tell that this one died rather quickly. Look at the thermal paste. And the one that worked for a quite long while. It's way, way thicker. Maybe even by the color you can see. The one in the left is way thicker. Yeah. Today is not my good day at all, probably not my good week. Zero chance of doing anything good. This thing is 100% coated in here with some sort of silicone, which is actually a really good construction. So this Livarno Lux are awesome, but not awesome for what I need this time, because I needed something fixable, and these things are not fixable. But I'm going to open this up, just maybe we can see what actually blew in here. Nope, sorry, this is impossible to be opened up, so I'm going to throw away all this gunk. And again, I really like these things. This is how I can open this. Ay. So my best bet at this point is to put on this one the good board, LED board, and hold it back together with, guess what, Kapton tape. And it's soldered in place and maybe working. And if you are wondering how I knew from two white wires what to solder where, this thing has markings on it. You can see maybe a plus down there and a minus somewhere in there. And I made a mark with a black pen on the negative wire when I desoldered it from the board. So yeah, now let's put this back together, plug it in or screw it in and see if we did anything good. If not, throw them away and that's about it. Not much else that I could actually do at this point. Screw it in and hopefully it works. I made sure I went over that edge because the Kapton tape can go in that groove and not just slowly drift away. So being in that groove in there makes sure it will not go away. Yeah, let's see. Yeah, this thing is not working. Let me just show you. It will be a lot of flickering light, so be prepared. Yeah, so let me try with the other board. I don't know at this point. Yeah, so I tested every single one of these LEDs with this thingy. Let me just show you, be prepared for some strong light in here. Well, wrong polarity. And I went like this all around these things with I don't know, about 10 seconds on each of these strands that I was testing. I even went with three of them to overload them. Couldn't find any issue. Here are the three that should have issues right here, the one that I'm pointing it with the needle. Let's change the polarity so we have the good one. Not even that one is failing. Of course they are not flickering in real life. So in all three of these, actually in the end, it seems the electronics failed. And let me just show you so you don't think I speak crazy stuff. Look at the color of these things. These two, this and this, are grayed out while this is way whiter. So this worked for a long while and heated up for a long while. This didn't have a chance to work. But the LEDs themselves are good on each of these things. So I don't know, I could hold on to them. I don't know if it's worth it honestly, but what I'm going to maybe try and do with this one, which is basically new, no, I'm not going to hold on to these ones. No, I've held on to too much stuff already for a while. This Gansky. Okay, I remembered I have this stupid Chinese thing, which I think I already fixed once in a really, really, really weird way. Okay, and I maybe put a bit too much glue. Let me do this in high speed. Yep, this is what I did. For every single one of the original LEDs that blew up, like this one blew up then, I've put four of standard LEDs in parallel. And it worked really well. The standard ones are still good, so I will simply snip them off. There is no reason to throw them away. But then the original LEDs crept out again. So what I am going to do is drill holes in this plate, put this plate on top of it, and not use all of the LEDs because this has a lower voltage. Use just part of them. So I give this thing a new life. Whatever. As you can see, it's kept on taped in here just so it doesn't short on anything, which I think it's a good thing. Let's do this. High speed, obviously. Just noticed that actually one of my fixed LEDs also crept out, but three of them were still working on this particular parallel bunch. I don't know, but yeah, so even if you do this, maybe put more, although LEDs in parallel, I don't know if they balance themselves quite well. If one of them starts to heat up more, probably draws more and more current. So anyway, this is cleaned, made sure there are no sharp edges to cut into these wires. I will put it face down and on top of it this thing, and yeah, hopefully we have something good. If not, at least we tried. Next to all of the bad decisions that I made today, I think I'm a bit unlucky. Let me tell, show you actually why. How can you drill directly through two LEDs in the middle of them? We don't care, we don't use this thing only as a heatsink, but really, in the middle of two LEDs? Yeah, whatever. I'm clearly unlucky today. Just wanted to add something else. If you have cheap Chinese bulbs, let me just give you some examples. This is one example. These ones are an example. This one actually. There are some like this that are actually without a proper plastic protection even on them. These things are quite bad from UV point of view, in my opinion, because look what happened to this wire here. Because this wire was on the outside soldered right here. So part of it that was exposed to the light produced by these LEDs lost all of its color. Yeah, I don't think that's a good thing happening. So let's take all of this thermal paste, put it in here, stick this thing on it and solder some wires and hope for the best. And count the LEDs. We need to know how many to actually use. So the battery just died in the middle of me doing stuff around here, so I needed to charge it, but we're back. We have soldered. On this side there were 18 LEDs. I soldered 19 in series, and I'm using, let me just try and show you. So we are starting from here, going all around on the exterior, and then going with these three back. So we have 16, 17, 18, 19 LEDs. That should be good. This one looks a bit weird, but just because there is some, how you call it, thermal paste on it, but should have zero real issues when working. So we've got that going for us, which is nice. Let's see if we have room for everything in here. Not at the moment. Yeah, this is a tricky thing. Everything needs to be lined up quite right in here to actually work. Something along this line. I'm not going to power it on as is. I don't really know if or let me just check if we have this is attached to any voltage or not. Hopefully not. It should be just free, but with Chinese stuff you never know exactly what you get. And we worked on them a little bit, so could be all sorts of wrong, so let's better check. Nope, from the negative we get nothing. Let's just check that it's working. It is. From the positive we get nothing. So in theory at least this radiator does not get any risk of having any sort of voltage to it, but never know. So this point, close it up and clean it up just a tiny bit all around with a fingernail, because why not? And then in high speed we will go to our friend Captain Tape. It should be called Captain Tape. Before going to test this thing, I just want to show you this type of bulbs. They blow up and you can make one good bulb from two of them, just take full elements. But honestly, if you have something like this, don't bother. It's not worth it. It wasn't worth it for the two bulbs that I show you how to fix today. In my opinion, it takes too much time. You do this only if you like to tinker around, or if you are in an area where it's hard to buy a bulb this second and you have tools and what you need around, or maybe they are really expensive LED bulbs in your area, or CCFL even, I don't know. It can be done, but I don't think I can say that I recommend doing this. Anyway, again, it can be done. So let's go and test this thing. Okay, you are seeing this for the first time, as I am also. What is that? Need to open it up and solder less LEDs together. Or wait, what? This isn't working. Something in the electronics doesn't like the new LEDs, so everything that I did is for nothing. So in this video we fixed one bulb and it looks bad. Tried to fix the second one and failed right up into the end, and I don't want to waste more time with this thing. I tried, doesn't work, that's about it. Maybe you learned something from this video, I sure did. And that's about it. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. In which case, maybe please give it a like. Check out my other videos. And as always, see you in the next one. Hopefully a more successful one. Bye.